Hey guys, this is Chris from Combo, and I'm here with the S9 and the S9 Plus, freshly launched by Samsung here at MWC 2018. Just going to do a super quick side-by-side to show some of the differences between the two in case you're thinking of picking one up. So first of all, as you can see, obviously the main difference is the actual size of the things. You've got a 5.8-inch S9 here on the right, and the 6.2-inch S9 Plus here on the left. They both rock that gorgeous infinity display design, just like the S8 and S8 Plus last year. So you've got slightly more slender bezels above and below the display, but apart from that, it's basically the same sexy, rounded, comfortable to clutch finish. Flip around to the back and you'll see they both rock this lovely glossy finish, just like the S8 and S8 Plus as well, exactly the same. You can get them in the same hues as well, black, blue or lilac purple, which is our particular favorite, as you can see the black here in the S9 Plus. They're both water-resistant handsets, so you can give them a good old dunking when required. And you know, it's one of the design differences with the S9 and S9 Plus is the fact that the fingerprint sensor is now rear-mounted. So it's nice and comfortable no matter which model you pick. You can just pick up the phone, your finger naturally falls onto that scanner, and it's always on, so it just unlocks straight into your desktops. And both phones also support a bit of facial recognition and iris scanning technology as well. They work in combination to securely unlock the handset, make sure it's definitely you that's using it. As for the display tech, besides the size, there's no real difference there either. It's a Super AMOLED in both cases with a bit of Quad HD Plus resolution. And in both cases, it's an absolutely stunning display. As you can see, nice punchy colors really, really stand out to really make your images come to life, and nice crisp images as well. Both phones also boast stereo speakers to the top and bottom of the display, and it can pump out Dolby Atmos quality sound to really give your movies or games or whatever you're busy doing a nice bit of oomph. In both cases, you get a nice bit of Snapdragon 845 action, so it's nice and nippy. In either case, you get 4 gigs of RAM on the smaller model and 6 gigs on the larger model, so slightly more memory. So should be a little bit better over time, but right now, we're not noticing any difference between them. Very, very slick and fast indeed. The battery tech, you get 3000 milliamp cell in the smaller S9. It's a 3500 in the S9 Plus. You might notice slightly better battery life. We'll, of course, be testing that in our full review. If you dive into the storage, there's a slight difference as well. You get 64 gigs in the smaller S9. You get a choice of up to 128 gigs in the larger model, so we've been told. And you can slip in a micro SD memory card in either handset of up to 400 gigabytes to just give it a nice bit of expansion. And both devices also support a bit of wireless charging, so you can just slap them down on your pad and then get them powered up whenever needed. Now, apart from the size and some of the specs, the biggest difference here is the camera tech, mostly the rear camera tech. As you can see, it's only a single lens camera here on the standard Samsung Galaxy S9, whereas that is upgraded to a dual lens camera on the S9 Plus. So the first lens is the same in both cases. It's 12 megapixel. It's actually a dual aperture and changes between f2.4 when the conditions are sort of pretty good, daytime and so on. And it can actually scale up to an f1.5 in low light conditions to suck in more light. But despite that, it takes 12 pictures simultaneously in order to cut down on grain and just make sure you're left with a nice crisp image. The second lens on the Galaxy S9 Plus is, again, it's 12 megapixel. This time it's a telephoto lens, f2.4. So you can just get a nice zoomed in image when you need to. Besides that, it's basically standard business as usual. They've got all the same features packed onto both handsets, as well as the same camera app. You can do the new super slow-mo feature on both of these blowers. And that basically records little snippets at 960 frames per second and can automatically detect when the action kicks off, so you don't have to manually push that shutter button. And in both cases, you've got a bit of AR emoji action as well, so you can actually create yourself in cartoon form and then get that on the go when you're messaging your mates. Both handsets run Android Oreo, and you get the same features on top, such as Samsung DeX and everything as well. And that, in a nutshell, is the Galaxy S9 versus the S9 Plus. As you can see, they're very similar in all but size, and with that camera tech as well, that's pretty much the main differences between them. Check out our full hands-on reviews both of these handsets and stay tuned for lots more sexy MWC 2018 coverage. Thanks for watching, everyone.